Hello, thank you for attending this webinar. Today, security is getting more and more sensitive for companies looking to secure their data and services. In this context, cloud still largely represents uncharted waters with new stakes, new challenges, and also new opportunities in terms of security. My name is Fabien Loquet. I'm a solution architect at Alibaba Cloud, and in this webinar, I'm going to present the major Alibaba Cloud security products. What they can do and what are their benefits. First thing first, a short introduction on Alibaba Group. As you may know, Alibaba was founded in 1999 by Jack Ma. It was initially a marketplace to connect customers with resellers. The group evolved over time and is now made of more than 60 BUs covering core commerce, mobile media, and entertainment and local services. All of these BUs are leveraging Alibaba Cloud Platform for their IT needs. Alibaba Cloud is a primary cloud provider in China. It is also the third most important cloud provider worldwide. We've got 19 regions globally present, and we've got 57 availability zones around the world. We've got more than 1,500 access points worldwide, with more than 1,000 only in China. We are globally present, and as a matter of fact, we are the only real global cloud provider with all our data centers connected to each other, including China. That being said, let's dive into our topic of interest for today. So this slide represents the security portfolio of Alibaba Cloud. They are the result of 15 years of securing our own services. And knowing that more than 40% of the attacks are originating from China, developing an expertise in the domain was just a matter of survival. Also, all the products presented here are used internally by Alibaba to secure its own services. The products can be divided in multiple layers. On the network layer, you can find the anti-DDoS, protecting denial of services attacks. You can also find the SELs and security groups for VPC, enabling the segmentation and isolation of customers' environments. Up one level, you can find the host and app layer. At this level, you can find the web threat detection service, scanning for vulnerabilities, and the web application firewall, or WAF, which is in fact a major product, protecting the application, whether it is a PC or a mobile device. Additionally, the content moderation service allows to identify inappropriate content useful for platform deals with user-generated content. At the next level, you can find the data layer with products to encrypt data in transit or at rest, with key management service and SSL certification service. At the utmost level, you can find the threat detection service, which is a risk management product, providing a security operation center to monitor the security level of your resources. Other products are in the roadmap, like a firewall as a service, which is embedded into Alibaba Network and removing the need to deploy third-party products like FortiGate or Checkpoint. On the other hand, Alibaba Cloud proposes a managed service for providing end-to-end security support 24/7 and all year long. In the rest of this webinar, I'm going to focus on only anti-DDoS, web threat detection, or WAF, content moderation service, and the threat detection service. So, first product is anti-DDoS. So, to begin with, what is a DDoS attack? So, DDoS attack is a distributed attack and coordinated, which includes potentially several thousands of machines, which are going to send a request to the target site or service. And the objective is really to saturate and to put it offline. It is an attack which is very localized in the time, and the idea is really to degrade the brand image of the company, or maybe to mask another attack. Like for example, if you're putting offline a security product, then it can mask the attack to another service. It's an attack that is very easy to put in place and to execute. Contrary to the majority of our competitors, we are separating anti-DDoS from CDN. So why is it such a problem to mix CDN and anti-DDoS? So in a typical CDN, one IP is serving multiple domains. In that case, if one of the domains is attacked, it will have consequences on all the domains that are served by this IP. Because for level 4 attacks, the interface will not be able to discriminate between which domain is attacked and which one is not. The consequence of that is that all the domains will suffer from service interruption, even those which were not the target of the attack. So this is one of the challenges that is facing the combination of a CDN and an anti-DDoS. And that's the reason why it's better to have a dedicated or exclusive IP. So this IP address will be associated to a single domain and will be redirected to our scrubbing centers. So what is a scrubbing center? A scrubbing center corresponds to a center which monitors, detects, and cleans the traffic. So it detects malicious traffic based on some patterns and automatically drops malicious traffic like DDoS and will reroute legitimate traffic to the origin server, to your origin server, which can be hosted in Alibaba Cloud or on a third-party cloud provider. So a scrubbing center can be seen as a proxy. And our scrubbing centers are spread over the world, and using technologies like BGP Anycast, we route and clean the traffic the closest to the origination of the attack. We have 4 scrubbing centers in China and 4 in the rest of the world, in the US, in Germany, Singapore, and Hong Kong. They all have a processing capacity of 2 terabytes per second. They can identify attacks like SYN ACFIN, UDP DNS, and NTP SSDP. Knowing that more than 40% of the attacks are coming from China, if your servers are hosted in Europe, for example, you will not see any malicious traffic coming from China because they will have been cleaned already in the scrubbing centers in China. The price of the solution depends on the level of protection that you're looking for. Do you want to be protected for attacks of 20 gigs, 100 gigs, 300 gigs? Do you want to pay by traffic? How many attacks do you want to be able to mitigate each month? So our solution is very flexible, and we're also offering a subscription for like 1 year, 3 years, which allow you to save monies. So in case of unlimited protection, you can mitigate any number of attacks during the month with a maximum bandwidth that is depending on the subscribed plan. The alternative protection is an insurance protection, which allows you to protect your domain against 2 attacks of 5 gigabits per second maximum each month. So one protection corresponds to the cleaning of traffic over a period of 24 hours after the detection of the starting of the attack. It is obviously less expensive than the unlimited protection. If for some reason you have exhausted the possibility of protection during the course of a month, for example, you've already mitigated 2 consecutive attacks, you still have the possibility to purchase additional protection days. Or you can even upgrade your plan to unlimited protection until the end of the month and then downgrade back to the insurance plan for the next month. To summarize, anti-DDoS product has several advantages. So the first one is it offers exclusive IPs, which is hiding your real IP address of your website or service. We also use scrubbing centers, which are leveraging BGP Anycast technology to monitor, detect, and clean the traffic at the closest of the source of the attacks. You also have the possibility to have unlimited protection, But you also have the flexibility to choose your type of protection, the number of attacks, the maximum bandwidth of the attacks, etc. So the next product is also very important for us. It is called the Web Application Firewall, or WAF. I will call it WAF in the rest of this webinar, which is also proposing an anti-bot solution. So how does WAF works? So it uses the same approach as an anti-DDoS and acts as a proxy with processing centers that are spread worldwide and which will route all the requests using BGP and IGAS technology. The processing center will then filter the request and forward only legitimate traffic to the origin server. So first, let's have a look at the different scenarios where the use of a firewall might be necessary. First, e-commerce. So Alibaba Group is obviously an e-commerce company, and we are dealing with the security of our services since a long time now, and we have done so successfully until now. So we are providing the technologies that we have developed all of these years to our customers so that they can also benefit from our expertise. So for e-commerce, one of the main threats that a company may face is that competitors will want to try to crawl and cipher your product catalog, your price catalog, and some information associated with your sales. So the frequency of the crawling will be very low, so it will be very hard to detect. In the domain of online travel agencies, the problems will be similar. You may have some competitors that will try to crawl for your promotions, but we can also try to make some bookings to cancel them afterwards, which can have significant impacts in your revenues. The last category is related to sensitive data. For example, for real estate agencies, you don't want your competitor to crawl for your information related to agencies, advertisement, and offers. So the real challenge is to be able to identify the behavior of a legitimate user against the behavior of a malicious user. The technologies, tools, and skills used to try to gather information are more and more sophisticated. In some cases, real humans are even used to work around the protections. Our WAF product analyzes the behavior of the user, is using data associated with him, and also uses machine learning in order to be able to discriminate if the user is human or a bot, or if the user is ill-intentioned. All of that is made possible thanks to the huge amount of data that has been accumulated by Alibaba on the behavior of its own users, which allows the WAF to put in place very efficient models in order to minimize the number of false positives. The WAF is very simple to deploy. So this diagram is presenting the high-level architecture of a deployment of a WAF instance. On the left, there is a user, which is using either a PC or a mobile application. At the center, you can see the WAF. So the platform offers a lot of optimization options depending on your needs. So overall, it's a platform as a service, and it's transparent for the customer as it acts as a proxy in front of your application API website. All you have to do, in fact, is to point your DNS to the CNAME of your WAF instance. Then you have to point your WAF instance to your origin server. You can additionally restrict the access of your origin server by setting up SELs to authorize only the IP range that is used by the WAF instance. In this manner, your origin server is fully protected and isolated from traffic coming from the internet. So here is a big picture of the different steps to filter the requests arriving to the WAF instance. So the very first step is leveraging IP reputation to make a first basic filter of the request. The next step tries to identify bots. It's leveraging models and algorithms to refine even more the filtering of the request. The next step is to use mechanisms like CAPTCHA in order to eliminate bots which could be smart enough to work around the previous steps. So at this step, 80% of the bots have been identified and filtered. There can still be some bots, so very advanced bots or even humans that could have passed all the different filters in order to crawl for information on your website. In this case, we can put in place some human support in order to provide advanced analysis and advanced support. So in the end, after the request have gone through all these steps, only legitimate traffic is allowed to access your service. So the IP reputation is leveraging a database that is maintained by Alibaba. So she is fed constantly by all the BUs from Alibaba Group, which are using WAF to protect their services. So it is a result of many years of daily battle against 200 million brute force attack, 20 million of website and intrusion attempts, and 1,000 of DDoS attacks. It represents a wide variety of attacks. And combined with all the information coming from the internet, we are taking advantage of a very precise IP reputation database. So for bot detection, so again, by leveraging our experience, we are able to build some advanced bot detection models based on entropy, which allow us to discriminate between a normal user and a bot. Using this model, we have the capacity of identifying the major parts of the bots. So in order to further identify bots, we have the possibility to set up CAPTCHAs. So in some users where we might think or we have some doubts that it's not a normal activity, we can request the user to validate a CAPTCHA. And last but not least, we are providing managed security services. So with incident response, with zero-day attack response, we're providing also training and consulting. We're providing incident reporting and also 24/7 all year long security operation center, which is reachable anytime and is leveraging expert supports. And so interestingly enough, we're running the biggest security team in the world. So now I'm going to quickly demonstrate the WAF. So you better understand the functionality and how it works. Okay, so you can find the application firewall on the left pane of the Alibaba Cloud console. So inside the WAF, make sure you're selecting the appropriate region. So whether you want to use it in China, mainland China or in international. So let's select international for this WAF instance. So we can see the overview page. We're going to dig into a specific website configuration. So we get one domain that is being protected, the traininglab.win. And then we can view the report if you want, and you can see that it's a normal state. So yeah, it's the normal website. So you can see that there is no difference between whether you're using web application firewall or directly your website. So it's totally transparent. So now let's simulate a malicious request to the website. So here we can see that it has been intercepted by the web application firewall and you get an error. So your request has not been forwarded to the origin server. It has been fully processed by the web application firewall and is returning an error to the end user. So if you ping your domain, you can see that it's handled by the web application firewall instance. So you don't see your origin server. It's really the proxy that you're seeing. So that if you go back into the overview page, you can monitor all the attacks that have been done on your domain. And finally, you can have access to reports of all the attacks on your domain. So this concludes the demonstration. So next security product is a Web Threat Inspection. So I will call it WTI in the rest of this webinar. So WTI is an automatic tool. You activate the service and you give it a domain name to be scanned in order to identify its vulnerabilities. If the domain name belongs to you and is managed by Alibaba Cloud, the scan can start directly. However, if the domain name doesn't belong to you, you have to fill in some authentication information before you can launch the scan. So WTI is leveraging Cloud Elasticity, which allows it to scan a huge number of websites simultaneously. WTI doesn't require you to install anything on your instances, and it also has very few false positives for everything like injection, files, redirection, etc. So why do we need to execute a scanning like this one? So if we look at the traditional on-prem servers, so represented in the middle of this slide, we have the typical situation like Fallows. So a zero-day vulnerability has been detected and everybody knows about it. So the IT administrator has to define first an action plan. So what services are affected? Do we have the vendor patch? And then you have to apply the necessary patches, test them, and make sure that they are functional. This overall takes a dozen of days. The hacker, however, has a big advantage because they are aware of the vulnerability at the same time as everybody else, even earlier in some cases. And they can scan to identify who is vulnerable and execute the attacks between 1 and 5 days after the vulnerability has been identified. So between 1 and 5 days for the hackers and 10 days for the IT administrators. So it lets very big security gaps for the companies. So with WTI, you are able to identify the vulnerabilities within 24 hours. If you're even more using a WAF, the service is constantly being updated in order to identify and correct the zero-day vulnerabilities, such like WannaCry, which we are able to block at the network level very fast. So next product we are going to dive in is a threat detection service. So the product acts as a SOC, a security operation center. So it provides monitoring, vulnerability management, reporting, configuration checking, incident response, and auditing. So in general, when a customer starts to have a lot of resources in the cloud, he begins to wonder, how will I monitor the security of my resources? Do I have the expertise to ensure the security of my infrastructure? Is there a way to know the system vulnerabilities? And do I have the possibility to generate a report about the security of the deployment of my infrastructure? So Cloud Threat Detection Service provides a security operation center in order to monitor the security of the resources of your infrastructure. As an example, this slide shows a screenshot of the overview page of the threat detection service. This screen shows 47 events related to security, with 7 vulnerabilities discovered, 4 baseline rules, and 5 unexpected assets. At the center, we have the top 5 of the most vulnerable resources with the number of vulnerabilities that have been discovered for each one. So it tells you to immediately look into why those resources have those vulnerabilities. Are they patched? Is their password strong enough? Etc. So at the bottom of the screen, we can see the evolution over the last 2 weeks, which vulnerabilities have increased, which ones have decreased. So under this overview page, you get other pages which allows you to get a more detailed or fine-grained view of the vulnerabilities and the security of your different resources. That's what I'm going to present right now. So this page presents the vulnerabilities of your resources. So in this screen, we can see the different types of vulnerabilities. Their criticity, whether it is low, medium, or critical. And you have the ability to do some searches and put in place some filtering in order to look at very specific vulnerabilities you want to dig into. You also have a settings panel which allows you to fine-tune the vulnerabilities you want to detect inside the Cloud Threat Detection Service. So then there is a baseline check page which allows you to define rules with respect to your host configuration, whether it is Linux or Windows. For example, regarding passwords, are they long enough? Are they complex enough? Do they have to be changed often? So you can specify the frequency. And the page is showing all your hosts and the ones that are not compliant with the rules that you've defined in this page. So you can also furthermore create rules that you can apply to groups of instances. So if you have a lot of resources, you don't have to apply the policy to each one of them. You can do that with bulk instances. So this can be very useful in that case. So Threat Detection Service allows you also to be notified when certain events or vulnerabilities have been detected. So you can set the level of the criticity as a threshold. So for example, you want to be warned only for urgent vulnerabilities or you want to be notified on everything. It really depends on what you want to get. So last page is the asset fingerprints. This page shows you all the ports that have been opened for a given host. This is useful to identify like ports that you don't want to be open, that could have been opened, for example, by a malicious software or by a hacker. So you also have the possibility to retrieve and aggregate all the logs from the operating system supported by Alibaba Cloud. So you can have an aggregated view of all the logs of all your hosts, and you can then do searches, perform analysis, and extra. Okay, so now the last product that I'm going to present to you is a content moderation service. So content moderation service is used internally in Alibaba Group, more specifically for Youku, which is the equivalent of YouTube in China. So it allows you to identify adult, violent or inappropriate content from videos, images or photos, and text. So the text is only supported in Chinese for the time being. So, but it's will be extended to other language soon. So the product is in SaaS mode, so it's software as a service. It can be easily integrated into a content management system, and it proposes, in fact, multiple ways of alerting when inappropriate content is identified. For example, it can automatically block the content from being published, or it can request for validation from the administrator. So this concludes this webinar on the presentation of the different Alibaba Cloud Security products. I hope you get a better understanding on the different functionalities and the benefits of our offering on the security domain. And if you want to have more information about this, you can create an account on our platform and start a free trial, or have a look at the documentation on alibabacloud.com. Thank you very much.